Hello, and thanks for checking out the video. Today, due to the hot weather, I'm trying to make sure that my hike is near to places where I can rehydrate. And, you know, I've mentioned before in the videos that the areas that I walk tend not to have springs or many water sources, any water courses. Streams are rare, things like that. So I've got to utilise a few pubs. And I've just stopped off at the first one. Had a bit of rehydration and I've got the long leg now, the long hike to the next one. So I'm sort of cracking on because the next one is actually, it's right out in the boonies and it doesn't really open very often. And not for long periods of time. It sort of only opens over the lunchtime period. I want to make sure that I get there. There's my second point. And again, rehydrate there and make it on to the next one, hopefully. This bit here, absolutely stonking hot, you know, there's no wind at all. Seems to be a bit of a sun trap. Yeah, sweating bullets now. Got to keep the pace up a little bit. I don't want to go 100 mile an hour like I normally do, but just keep the pace up to get to the second rehydration point. On now to the third rehydration point. Hopefully not quite as far as the between the last two, but it's still quite a way to go. But the pressure's not on because it does stay open all afternoon and on into the evening. But obviously I'd like to get set up camp-wise before the evening starts. So yeah, just keep a reasonable pace on, but this is a bit shaded here and a little bit breezy. So after the cooling rehydration I've just had, I'm feeling slightly better now, ready for the next leg. to the final leg is to find the campsite. It's a bit of woodland that I've camped before, and yeah, I'm hoping it will all be okay and not changed since the last time I was there. Not too far, you know, I'm not sure I'll be able to cut across land up here or not, but I'm hoping to really make it a short leg, this one. But if not, I'll go all the way around. We've got long evenings at this time of year, so hopefully it'll give me time to gather a bit of wood and get ready for supper. I think I can cut a bit of time out. Thank you. Tonight it's vegetable kebabs on a bed of rice. So get the rice on first. Cover with twice as much water as rice. Get that on the go. Just prep up the kebabs. Got some onion, red onion. Have some mushrooms and tomatoes in there, and what's in here? I can't remember. Courgette and red pepper, I think. I can get it out. Yeah. I brought these metal skewers with me because they're just easier than trying to use a green stick. You know, when you're trying to use a green stick as a skewer, when you're skewing vegetables, you have to get it down to a really small diameter, you know, ideally about 2 mil like these are, which is almost impossible to do with a stick that you're shaving down. If it's a large diameter, it tends to split open the vegetables that you're skewering. So it's handy, and it's worth bringing some metal skewers sometimes, I feel. Just makes life a little bit easier when threading the vegetables onto them. You know, the vegetables won't split and fall off, hopefully. Well, not too much anyway. got too many vegetables to go on this really. Yeah, that rice is pretty much done. Raise it right up away from the heat. I'm going to baste them with this stuff, and it's just vegetable oil, obviously. Half vegetable oil, half ketchup, and a good splash of soy sauce. Yeah, I'll just sprinkle a bit of general purpose seasoning in it as well. And just a little basting stick here. Ideally you'd use a brush to paint this stuff on, but we haven't got a brush. We've just got what the wood supplies, which is wood. Yeah, without a brush it's going to be a slow job smearing it on, but yeah, we're only sitting here watching it, so why not? Slide these vegetables on top of the rice. Yeah, it's about 5:15 in the morning now. And that was a good night. Yeah, it was a mild night. I've got no signal here, but the last time I looked at the weather prediction, it was going to stay at least 1 or 2 degrees above 10 degrees. So I think 10 degrees centigrade is about 50 Fahrenheit. So it was always predicted to stay above that. So it was always going to be a warm night, which makes this kind of primitive setup without a sleeping bag that much more bearable, you know. I mean, you can feel the chill kick in as the night goes on. I kept the fire ticking over. I didn't really need to keep it going very hot. Just a small fire is enough to warm up this little shelter and just take the edge off that 10, 11, 12 degrees, whatever it was. So pretty comfortable, really. Comfortable all round.